Hi, welcome to this question right here. So this is the type of question where you don't just cross multiply right away, okay? You have to remove something else before you can do the shortcut. So what happened is we've got a 4 over 5 plus 5 over 4 x equal to 1 over 3. Now, the idea is simple. You want to solve the x which is here, right? You have to remove anything that's the furthest away from it first. So the 4 over 5 has to go first. So what we'll do is we'll keep a 5 over 4 x as it is. And we're going to subtract 4 over 5 from both sides, okay? So you have to subtract the 4 over 5 from this side and from this side. So now it is still mathematically the same thing. So if you subtract the 4 over 5 from here, that 4 over 5 is gone from the question. Then it's just 1 over 3 minus the 4 over 5. Now, what I would recommend, if you're going to show all your work, then you will have to combine these two fractions together. Now, when it comes to fraction, adding and subtracting, you have to keep the denominator the same, okay? That's a 3 and that's a 5, so it doesn't work. So you have to find the lowest common denominator between the 3 and 5. Now, the lowest common denominator between the 3 and 5 would be the 15, okay? So if you want to change the 3 to 15, you have to times it by 5. So you do the same to the bottom, you have to do the same to the top. So 3 times 5 is 15, and 1 times 5 is still 5. Now, this one over here, because you want to get to 15, right? So mathematically, you'll be thinking that, okay, 5 times 1 gives me 15 times 3. So if you times the 3 to the bottom, then you will have the times by 3 to the top as well. So 3 times 4 is 12, okay? So just let me write down the work in a different color so you will see what happened there. So what happened here is we times this by a 5, we times that by a 5, we times that by a 3, and we times that by a 3. So right now, we got a 5 minus 12, they're all over 15. So if you want, I would recommend that you actually do it this way. Change the common denominator into a 1 denominator. You can do that. Then the top is just 5 minus 12. So you won't do anything weird, okay? So you just keep the denominator the same, but this time you would just go 5 minus 12 on the top. I think it's negative 7 if I remember correctly. Yes, and that's negative 7 over 15 so far. On the left-hand side, the 5 over 4x is still waiting for you. I would recommend you write the x right beside the 5, okay? Make it look a little bit nicer. Now, at the very, not the very end right now, we're trying to solve the x still. But this time, if you look at your question now, it's 5x over 4 equal to the negative 7 over 15. Two fractions on the either side of the equal sign. What can you do? Cross multiply. So I will actually now take the cross multiplying method. I'll take the 4 and multiply it to the negative 7 and take the 5 and multiply it down to the 15. Why do I do that? I want to keep the x by itself on the top. So now the x is on the top by itself. It's alone, but that's what we want. Take the 4 times the negative 7. It's negative 28. And take the 5 times the 15. That's too big for me. 75. Okay? Then we got 28 over 75. Is it possible that we can reduce this number? Let me get a quick calculation here. Nothing we can do. Final answer, negative 28 over 75. Thanks for watching.